which I've had the privilege of guiding many fine young athletes, but never one as outstanding as the one we're about to nominate today for this year's top contender in our National Bingham Foundation Award. I know ordinarily I present this player myself, but today it seems all the more appropriate for me to present this honor to a fine young lady who just happens to be the daughter of W. Richmond Bingham, sponsor of this award. May I present Patricia Bingham?
Tom on the field, but now we have a chance to cheer him up close as well. I know I cheer every time I'm reminded that Tom's my boyfriend. Let's give a big cheer to this year's Bingham Foundation nominee award, Tom Marlowe.
Thank you, thank you. But I won't feel quite worthy of even discussing any awards until after we win last year's. This whole season has been filled with good news here at Kate, and I plan on continuing that good news right out to the end.
Marked on my calendar like dental appointments.
Well, great. That's just like old times. know what? I've been thinking a lot about these conversations.
I'm sure our paths will cross again. Come along, Carney.
Little Penny, bring me luck. Because I was the guy who picked you up.
Hey, Boots.
Goodbye, Coach.
Goodbye. Where do you think you're going?
I'm leaving. I just quit.
You quit? You're the best trainer in these 48 states.
Well,
you can't quit.
I broke a mirror this morning.
That's why you're leaving? Come on, Coach. I need you.
I'll be back in 7 years.
Oh, Coach, not even you can break a mirror big enough to take down the team that I've built up around Tom Martin. Hey, come on. Let's get to work. What do you got in here?
Horseshoes.
Line up, Chief. Your Sheba's calling.
What's up, babe?
I heard the game ball sold out.
Conference championship. Tom's last game. Even the coach is having a tough time getting ticket to this
game. Oh, boy, then it's your lucky day. Babe O'Day is going to select one of you to take with me to the big game.
You can't take us. Besides, aren't you high on Pete Saunders?
Wake up, man. It's 1928. Flappers are different now. Our skirts are short, and so is our pitch. I'm nobody's girl. I'm free, independent, and self-sufficient.
Then why do you need us?
I need a ticket. Beef's gonna get me a good seat, but I'm breaking up with him.
You're breaking up with Beef, who destroyed half of Huxley's team last week, Saunders?
Yeah, he's too possessive. I can't even talk to another boy without Beef trying to kill him.
I'll let you get out of here!
Hey, what's going on?
Leave him alone, Beef. They're my date this Saturday. Date!
It's your microphone,
baby. Beef, I didn't want to tell you until after the game. We broke up. Yesterday.
Hey, what are you talking about? Which one of you guys is trying to be my babies, you born rat!
Beef, you can't stop me from having a new boyfriend. I believe you can free love.
Babe, you know I don't understand when you talk about money. Well, that's foolish type of baggage. You guys see right where you are.
Let's go!
Wait, hurry up, girls! Okay, girls, you can take off your blindfolds. We're here. This is where Millie and I come to be alone with Tom Marlowe.
Lau and I sit behind these bushes and watch Tom exercise every day on his way to practice.
Imagine being on the same grass as Tom Marlowe.
He's the best fullback Tate ever had.
He's the greatest fullback college football ever had.
He's the greatest fullback I ever saw. Tom.
Here he comes!
He's a clown and he's a wit. The poets say
Pat, what are you doing here?
Besides destroying the soles of my shoes, I wanted you to know that if Tate wins the big game on Saturday, Daddy will be donating a very large sum of money to the athletics department.
Well, tell Daddy to get his checkbook ready. I'll be playing the game of my life.
Good. Then we'll be such the envy of the victory celebration. After you become a big football star, we can get married.
Married?
Oh, and Daddy will buy a big place of our own in Westport.
Pat, right now, all I can think about is that astronomy test and getting back to practice.
Leave the rest to me.
There he is!
Hi, Bob-sisters! You came all the way down here to help me with my bags. Now my sisters can help me decide what I'm going to wear for the big game. You know, being Tom Marlowe's girlfriend is a big responsibility. Actually, it's more pressure than being the president's wife. No one really cares what Mrs. Coolidge wears. Her hopes spent only on the radio.
That's been yours, Randall?
This is 100 more payments.
Pretty risky buying a second-hand flipper. Check in the hood.
What do you know? Got my car in college. So I didn't check it enough.
What?
Check the back seat. This back seat ain't even warm yet.
If you was its owner, it's about to get a lot colder.
Wait and see. My Roadster will be the most popular struggle buggy on campus.
Only if you rent it out on the weekends. So, why is our third string start practice, huh?
Coach said to stay away, you know. Secret weapon. Too risky to get on dirty, like you hurt, or,
The amount you play, your uniform will stay as clean as your back seat.
Not with me back here.
Oh, hey, what are you doing back there?
You're cute. And you're my game for Saturday's game. Got tickets, don't you?
Yeah, but you're a beach girl, and you got footprints all over my new logo seat!
He's old news. You're my sheep now.
What?
Already attracted campus girls, huh?
You're quite the ladies man there,
Bobby. See, I told you guys.
Yeah, and Beef would be real glad if all that babe's taken care of.
What?
Come on, guys. Let's leave these two lovebirds alone.
Lovebirds? What?
Thanks, Stallion. This is the first time I've been without a boyfriend since I've been on a long skirt. Big boy get in on a weak market.
Why do you want me? I'm only a substitute on the football team. I'm not very handsome, and all my money's tied up in IOUs, the whole $4.
I don't want a rich man. I don't want a handsome man. I don't want a clever man.
You want me?
Right. Well, it's the big boy. Enough.
big news. I gotta see Coach.
What's up, Freshie?
Tom Marlowe failed his astronomy class. They just posted the grades, and there was a saving rat. Now we can't play in the game on Saturday. What are we gonna do?
Calm down, Freshie. Here comes Coach. He'll know what to do.
Hey, I'll meet the guys and get a support rally going. Well, quick, give me a push, Fresh.
Now, Pete, you keep very quiet. Let me break the news to Coach very gently.
Coach?
Tom Miles is trying to be dead!
So what?
Don't you remember the new school rule? No sport if you fail an exam!
I knew it! Oh, my fault. I told the coach I was a jinx. Oh.
Coach, that's not going to help. But we better call the coach right away.
I better tell him alone. This could be dangerous. The last time the coach heard bad news, he mistook a water boy for a tackling dummy.
That's what they're for, though.
B, aren't you supposed to be running laps? Get moving! B. The only football player in history to trip over the white stripes.
Hey, Professor, get me from the sour apple tree. Well, hey, Professor, get me from the sour apple tree. Well, hey, Professor, get me from the sour apple tree. And that'll be the end of her. Well, hey, Professor, get me from the sour apple tree. Well, hey, Professor, get me from the sour apple tree. Well, hey, Professor, get me from the sour apple tree. And that'll be the end of her.
Ah! Only the words!
Calm down, everyone. Here comes the coach.
Oh, you imagine after all these years, kind, Kenyon's finally getting revenge? That's why she's here at Tate. To destroy me. She hates me. She hates football, too. Can you imagine hurting football for grades? What's next? Academic scholarships. Wait a minute. I think we all ought to go over there and tell her just what's most important here.
Yeah!
Thank you.
Today after school, I talked to Professor Kenyon, and she says I can take a makeup test tomorrow. So, I'm going to go hit the books. I hope you don't mind if I just practice. We're going to beat Colton, Coach.
Tom will never pass that test tomorrow.
You're right! During football season, Tom doesn't know a star from a chorus girl.
Well, wait a minute, there's got to be someone around here that's an astronomy expert. I mean...
Hey! What about Pat?
Yeah.
She got an A in astronomy, and she is his girlfriend!
I'm going to take her to my office right away.
Well, I believe just as you do that football should not be allowed on college campuses.
I don't think I went that far, Connie.
Oh. Well, I just don't see what all the girls see in these football players. When I fall in love, it's going to be for the perfect man. He'll be kind, sensitive, caring, share all of my interests, and most important, enjoy spending Saturday afternoons anywhere but at the football games. I just won't settle for anything less. Even if I don't get married until I'm 30. Did you ever find that man?
The perfect man?
No.
Still, there was one man. And he was nothing like what I thought I was looking for. But we had some pretty great times.
Well, what happened?
He couldn't accept that I had other interests besides him. That was back 15 years ago. It was very different back in 1913. Men weren't always enthusiastic about women having their own careers. Still, we had some pretty wonderful times. And I thank my lucky stars. Speaking of stars,
oh, yes, I know, we better get back to work.
Easier to keep Tom's mind on astronomy with her. She
She does have a lot of ironing to do, but I suppose we'll say good old Titus and wait till tomorrow.
Well, good. I will meet Tom at the library.
See, Cook, you can always count on me.
All right, what we need now is a big play.
Oh, yeah, but Kenyon still has the ball.
Then it's time to get off defense and back on offense. Do whatever you used to do to soften her up. Maybe she'll go easy on Tom's exam.
Well, I'm not going to beg. Well, I mean, I'm not going to lose my dignity just for a football game.
Well, even if it means beating Colton, winning a conference championship, and beating Rockne as coach of the year.
What was the song she always liked?
Yeah,
she thought I was the bee's knees of my old varsity friends.
That's it, Coach. I'd leave you my rabbit's foot, but it's my last one. And every rabbit between here and Vermont is hiding from me.
Thank you.
watch tracks, Randall. I'm here to coach you to your mind signal. Take off that stupid rumble.
I can explain.
Yeah, very colorful, friend. Yeah. I'm here to coach you to your mind signals. They're simple. 5-8-1, off tackle, to the right. And 1-4-1 red. Howard play to the left. They're quite simple. What's that you doing?
It's a secret play called around the end
and under the back. Wise guy, huh? Anyway, I'm going to coach you a new line play. You need help with them.
The man for it.
Get down. I'm coming at you. It's up to you to stop me.
What?
Down. Set. Hut! God!
Sorry.
This time, you come at me. It's up to me to stop you.
Okay.
Down. Set. Try to tackle me?
Oh, I was afraid I was gonna hurt you.
Hurt you? If you hurt me, I'll kill myself. Oh. Down. Set. Pound him so flat, he'll be able to play him out of control. I'll see you later, Brandon.
See you, Lee. You hear that, Dane? I'm gonna be recorded.
No, but that was a very interesting scrimmage. You're stronger than you look.
Yeah. Well, can you just get out of here?
Not until I get my case.
Hang with me, Lee.
Kiss me, Dan.
Oh, you had your go. I gotta get out of here.
To learn?
My whole future depends on how well I do here.
listening to a word I'm saying.
Sure I am. Big Dipper, Little Dipper. I understand how you feel about learning. My whole future depends on how well I play football.
Is that why you're showing so little interest in astronomy?
I'm sorry, but during the season, my mind just drifts to football.
Then, why did you take astronomy?
I always liked studying the stars as a kid.
You studied astronomy as a boy?
Well, sort of. Whenever my father would take us fishing, we'd sit in his boat. He'd tell us stories about everything up there. He could even tell which fish were biting by which stars were shining the brightest. If that group of stars was the brightest, it was going to be a good catfish day. And that meant good trout. And if that group was the brightest, he'd just pack us up and we'd go home.
And you still believe this?
Well, that's what he believed, and we never went hungry.
Do you always tell everyone your childhood stories?
Oh, no. So don't go tell everyone how my father catches fish.
Not even Pat?
I don't think she'd be very interested in how my father catches fish. She's a wonderful girl, but we don't have very much in common.
Well, then what keeps you two together?
Well, I'm a star football player. Pat likes that. She even talks about us getting married, which would make me part of the Bingham family. Their house is like a palace. My dad would be so impressed.
That doesn't seem like a very good reason to be getting married. But I'm glad she found Pat to fall in love with.
Well, I didn't say I was in love with Pat. My idea of love is being with someone who will let me be myself. Someone who will know me really well and like me anyways. Someone who spends Saturday afternoons with me doing all sorts of different things. Do you know what I mean?
Perfectly.
But then I think about the Bingham Foundation and what it could do for me and for the school. Is it wrong for Bella to try to be practical?
There are so many kinds of riches.
Help, Johnson.
Bring back any memories?
Yes, you remind me of a silly sophomore I once knew.
Oh, no, Charlotte, I seem to remember that you thought that silly sophomore looked pretty good.
That's because I was an even sillier freshman. Bill, why are you...
I'm Speedy. Remember, that's always what you used to call me, Charlie.
I remember. Bill, I hope you don't think that by coming here and carrying me down memory lane, that I'm going to pass Tom on his test.
Oh, of course not. I came down here because I wanted to see you again.
Really?
Sure. It was great seeing you this afternoon. You look... just the same.
Thank you. You look... similar. And you bought new shoes without cleats.
Oh, I'll never forget that night I walked into the victory dance. Where are my football spikes? Oh, come on. They were the only black shoes I had.
These must be easier to dance in.
Charlie, I've always wanted to apologize for that night. You must have left that dance with Marcus and the football team we played that afternoon.
You danced fine. But I doubt we've given Vernon and Irene Castle much competition.
One smile from you always brightened my day.
That's very nice.
Oh, you know I'm not good with words.
And I'm not much of an athlete.
No, I've been thinking a lot about this, haven't you?
Really?
I'm not a poet. How will I know it? I've never been a raven. But when I look at you, I rave a bit, it's true. You're the cream of my coffee, you're the salt in my soup. You will always be my necessity, I'd be lost without you. You're the starch in my clothes, you're the lace in my shoe. You will always be my necessity, I'd be lost without you.
Billy, any
week.
Yeah, babe, I thought you never played poker before.
Half the dinner's left. Come on, boys, I won your tickets fair and square. Now pay up.
What's going on? Kenny's still great.
Bobby!
You owe me a pair of pants.
No horse feathers, Bobby. We're going to be rich. Look what I won. Tickets to the game that we can sell and make $50.
I paid for your walls with these, and Tom doesn't play tonight.
What's the matter, Bobby? What's going on? We can't let school get us depressed. Well, guys, the reason why we're in college is to have fun, right? We've always got knowledge, not we should be taught to dance right here in danger of the state we need to bring.
Blue, winter, bunch of blood, wave, now flag.
credit for this one, Connie. Dear, sweet, beautiful
well,
Connie.
Stop.
I won't stop. Connie, you're my coach, my team, my cheering section. Will you go with me to the victory celebration after the game? I want everyone to see how special you are.
Well, what about Pat?
She'll understand. She'll probably even be happy for us.
You really think so?
I don't ever gamble, sweetheart, I refuse. Not because I need to, simply because I always lose. Lucky boys who gamble tell me that it pays. But I've got luck that beats their luck a thousand different ways. Lucky love.
Ah!
$50 that he wants. And you know that $50 you have? It'd make us rich.
Steve's so dumb.
He doesn't suspect a thing, so we can...
Turn around. Hey, here you go.
Oh, I didn't think it's gonna be Jake. This is gonna be so cool. We're gonna win.
Yeah.
explain to you before we met here the other day?
You got the description of one of us, Ray. And it isn't you.
I'm only joking. Look.
You look beautiful.
Well, what's wrong, Tom? I just know you're going to play wonderfully. I'm already proud of you.
You won't be when you're in eye practice, to tell you.
Look, there's a problem with my ticket.
Your ticket's fine, Connie. I can't split it with Pat. There's too many other people depending on me to marry her. The future of Kate's football program? Scholarships for young players? I don't even know. I'm sorry.
No, don't be. We really were not suited for each other anyway. Me in football, you in science. What's much better this way? Here, Pat should be the one wearing it.
No, I want you to wear it. Every play, I'll still be looking for you in the stands. I hope you understand. Thanks, Connie. I'll see you at the game. You'll be sitting next to Pat. You're the best girl a guy could ask for.
He passed. Although, his essay answers
of his head drifting into the clouds.
Well, something must have distracted him.
Someone. You. The moon has long, beautiful brown hair. Let's hope for his sake he's not that distracted in the game today.
Well, I hope he is. I hope Colton makes a home run every time Shane has the ball.
You must really love him.
Well, I hate him.
I hated a football player once, too. Always felt that I was competing with football.
What did you do?
Nothing smart. At the big game, I dressed in the other team's colors. And when he saw me sitting in the stands, he got so confused he ran in the wrong direction. That play won the game for the other team. Ended up transferring to another college.
Well, that's different. This isn't about football. But Tom's wearing Pat.
It's not much different. I should have stayed and fought rather than leaving.
Oh, it's too late now. I don't ever want to see Tom again on the radio.
Professor Kenyon.
Mr. Pooch.
The coach asked me to bring this to you.
Thank you. Mr. Pooch.
The coach told me to make sure you wouldn't burn the letter before reading it.
Don't be silly.
Fine. I asked Pooch to bring this to you.
The coach hopes you're still not mad at him, and he wants to thank you for putting all your feelings aside about him and football, and giving Tom Marlowe a second chance. I also hope...
Why don't you just tell me what else the coach has written?
Well, he hopes he'll forget the last game you attended and come to the game this afternoon. He sent a ticket. Oh, and he said to remind you that the school colors are red and gray.
I'd love to come, but after the last tape game I attended, I think it'd be safer if I just listened at home.
He didn't think you'd come. Too bad, too. The coach has been in a lot better mood since he started teaching here, and coaching better than ever, too.
Why is that?
Well, for one thing, you got him back to his telescope.
Telescope?
Why, sure. He spends hours looking through it every night, making new plays for the team.
Bill Johnson looking at the stars.
Says he's always been interested. Says if the star formations stay together the way they do, why can't his team?
Really?
And it's been working, too. But it all comes down to what happens today. Let's just hope Tom Marlowe plays well.
Well, of course he will. He's the star football player, isn't he?
Has been. But the word is some science. Has him a little shaken up.
Honey.
As long as she's in the stands, he'll be fine. Otherwise, that can be the end of the coach's dream.
But I don't think she's... Well, we'll just have to make sure Tom sees Connie sitting in the stands this afternoon. Thank you, Mr. Pooch.
Just Pooch. Man's best friend.
Section 2, row 7, seat 14.
Oh!
Back in the locker.
Marlo, are you in here?
Here I am, Coach. Sorry I'm late. I had some personal business to straighten out.
I'll take it on the field, Marlo. Come on. I got some new places to show you. Hey, by the way, congratulations on passing that test.
Oh, thanks. I don't know how I did it, though. The entire test, all I could think about was this girl I just met. I can't think of anything else when we're apart.
Just be careful, okay? Girls can do strange things to a guy.
Don't worry, Coach. I'll play better than ever this afternoon. Con will be there, and I know right where she's sitting. Section 2, row 7, seat 14. As long as she's in that seat, there's no stopping me.
Just make sure I don't catch you running down the wrong side of the field, okay?
Section 2, row 7, seat 14! Oh, Connie's not at that game. Tom doesn't play. Tom doesn't play. Dane loses, and if Dane loses, we lose the bet. And if we lose the bet, whatever B best plan for me is nothing compared to what happens to a guy who can't pay off his gambling debts.
Oh, well, pull yourself together, Bobby. No one's gonna lay a hand on my Bobby. Just let me take care of everything. And I'll give you my ticket.
I left it in my room!
No, it's all right. I know how to climb in.
Oh, thanks? I was never the marrying type, but if we win tonight, I'll quit being a crazy chic on campus.
Yeah, and I'll never wear a skirt covering my knees again. I'll make sure that seat's filled, Bobby Randolph.
Hey, babe.
Mm-hmm.
Why didn't you use the door?
Oh, right!
State fans here at Tate Stadium this afternoon. And Tate goes back into the locker room at the end of the first half with Colton leading 3-0.
Good job, you guys. Yeah! We need to fumble that ball. Yeah! We need to miss those tackles. Yeah! We need to fill those interceptions. Yeah, yeah! Good job, you guys.
Woo!
Yeah!
Good job. Good job. Man, I don't get it. I should be out there playing. Best player on the team, and what do I gotta show for it? Clean jerseys and splinter scars? Man, great coach we got.
What does he know about football?
What does he know about men? What does he know about being the best guard coach on this side of the...
Sit down, Randall. What is wrong with you guys? You're playing football like a bunch of prep schoolboys, and that is not the kind of football I taught you. Collins, will you please start tackling like you've got some guts? Football players don't just stop when you tag them. Rhodes. Where's Rhodes? Wherever the heck he is, man, he's calling plays like it's a square dance. Oh, I'm sorry, maybe he forgot that the board has been legal for, say, about 15 years. That's a joke, guys, it's a joke. Now, Beef, I'm changing your name to Pork Chop.
Sorry, Coach, the real guy really wants all your things. Bitch!
Save it, Beef. Save the date, Raylan, for Marlo. Right, Marlo? Now. The purpose of this game is to run with the ball, not sit there and count the laces. Ah, you forget a man who can't play with a man who won't. What is wrong with you? Don't you just realize it? If you start playing it, I'll play with you.
I'm sorry, Coach. I'll be okay.
Oh, hallelujah. Oh, come on, guys. Now, I love each and every one of you, but I gotta be proud of you, and the school wants to be proud of you. And you know what? All those frozen grads out there getting pneumonia, they want to be proud of you too! So, how about we go out there and show them that you're worthy, sons of Tate!
Yeah!
Come on, what's the matter with you guys? You are the coach. So what? We lost the first half. We still have to win, right?
Right.
There's one thing to think of when you're through. There are others much worse off. Again blue, if they're dreaming,
on its way. Colton leads 3-0. We're now ready for Tate's first play in the third quarter. The hands off to Donald. He takes the ball and heads straight for the right sideline. And is down for a 5-yard loss. Marlowe still seems to have a very hard time getting unraveled here today. It's now second down and 15 for Dane. Once again, Tom gets the ball. Once again, Tom runs straight for the right sideline, and once again, he's down for no gain. I don't know what Tom's looking for, but every time he gets the ball, he heads straight for the right sideline and looks into the stands. It's now third down.
Out of my way! I'm late for the kick!
Hold it! Where's your ticket?
It's a matter of life and death! If I'm not in those stands, Tay won't win. If Tay doesn't win, I won't win against Mary.
No ticket, no game.
But they're in my lobby's bedroom, and all the windows are locked. I don't have time to explain, but Tom Marlowe's looking for me in those stands.
So you're who he's been looking for all afternoon?
Well, yes. Well, not really, but when he sees me dressed like this, he'll think I am who he's actually looking for. And if he doesn't find me, Tay won't win, and Tay doesn't win either.
I know. Mary Tom Marlowe.
No, I'm not going to marry Tom Marlowe. I'm going to marry Bobby Randolph. But he's not going to be around if he loses a bet on today's game. Which it was if Tom doesn't see me in the stands. He's in love with me. Well, actually not me. But here's the thing, I am who I'm actually not, who he's in love with. Well, Tom, I mean.
Nobody gets through my gate without a ticket.
I'll fight someone who really cares about this school.
And he's down again. It's time Coach Johnson sends Tom down to the showers after another 5-yard loss.
I told you already, no ticket, no game. Now go away before I get someone to lock you up.
Excuse me?
You're not getting into this game, wedding or no wedding.
Wedding? Coach Johnson gave me the ticket to today's game. It's very important that I attend.
Oh, so it's Coach Johnson now. You sure get around.
How dare you? I'm a professor here.
Ticket?
Well, I gave it back to Pooch, but I know there's a place reserved for me.
And there's a place reserved for me in Bonneville.
It's very important that I'm here today. You see, the last Tate game that the coach invited me to, I was an undergraduate
that's
here, so I'm 15, and
down
I wore
the wrong
colors, which caused quite a problem for everyone, and I realized how silly the whole thing was, and ironically, what I'm wearing today is going to save the game.
See what I'm wearing? Ironically, that means you don't get into the game without a ticket.
Unless Tom Marlowe sees me sitting in the stands, the conference championship will be lost, along with the entire sports department, and possibly your job will become a thing of the past. I won't forget you.
And once again, Tate wastes a series of downs by giving the ball off to Tom Marlowe. I don't understand Tate's game plan. Colton has possession.
Well, I hope I'm not too late for the game.
Sure, just let them hear. Look, lady, no ticket, no game.
But I tore it up and threw it away when I got angry this afternoon.
Oh, and you're not angry anymore.
No, see, I've been listening to the game on the radio, and Tom's been playing so terribly, he proved that I'm the one he really loves. Oh, it's very important that he sees me in my seat. It could...
I already know. In the past championship, they did for a sporting program that you married to possibly keep my job. What's next in prohibition?
Let me go! My boyfriend's very inimical with people I'll be trying to help!
By sneaking the team's locker room. I know you're kind.
It's up to me to make sure Tay wins!
I saw the locker room window and pull her out by her feet.
This is an outrage! I was not trying to sneak into the game to save money!
I've gone this one dangling outside the top of the fence and back.
My shoe got caught!
They're multiplier!
Professor Kenyon? Babe? What are you guys doing here? Well, I didn't think she was coming, so I thought I could look like her by dressing like this. And I had to try and save my Bobby. And I wanted Tom playing his best for Coach Johnson.
They must buy clothes together. Do you know that?
I didn't know she was a them, but I'm afraid this will be long, guys.
Well, then leave them right here with you to listen to the game. We'll be right over there. If they get in each other, just call them walking home.
And that's when I realized Tom really loves me and not Pep. I was just fighting for him, like you said. We were all just trying to do the right thing. And look where it's at. Sharing the stage with the Keystone Cup. The game isn't over yet. It's no use. We're not getting past them. Now even if Tate wins, Tom will never know I was here to cheer for him. There's 5 pieces of my Bobby from here to Miami. Come on, girls, cheer up. There's got to be something we can be happy about. I'm sure Coach Johnson and I will have a good laugh about this.
15 years from now? Well, Bobby always liked a warmer climate.
At least Tom will be part of the family after he marries Pam.
You see, we do have something to be grateful for.
Life is just a bowl of cherry. Don't take it serious. Life's too mysterious. You work, you wake, you worry. So and in what have you got when you go, go, go? So keep repeating it's the very not true, so not whole. Something in life, children in clothes, so happy in the rooms, or together alone. Life is just a bowl of cherries. So live and laugh at it all. Life is just a bowl of cherries. Of course, don't take it serious. Life's too mysterious. You work, you wait, you worry. So when and what have you got when you go, go, go? So keep repeating it's the very.
Tom stopped dead again. He seems frozen. There's a player coming towards him. Wait, it's his own teammate.
teammate Bobby Reno. And he's thrown away the football to Bobby Reno and dropped the touchdown. Bobby Reno is
putting money out of the only girl I've ever loved.
Only trouble is, I bet I've lost every chance of having her ever love me again.
Try that. Love like football. In 1909, Reeves returned a punt for 90 yards with 10 seconds remaining. In 1912, Mahoney picked up a thumb